है
तो मैं भी फिर यहाँ पे पांडे से कुछ
म्यूट।
Am I
यस।
Good evening, fellow Toastmasters and the dear guests. Welcome to the meeting number 409. If you want to see a sharp change in your personality, your communication skills, and public speaking skills, then, my dear friends, Toastmasters is a place which you can look for. The Toastmasters Club has already served and is serving a large number of people to achieve their personal goals, develop their personality, and boost up their confidence. People join Toastmasters Club for numerous reasons, some for enhancing their personality, some for making their betterment. Now I would like to share you all the mission of our club. We provide a supportive and positive learning experience in which members are empowered to develop communication and leadership skills, which results in greater self-confidence and personal growth. Cricket has been an emotion to me. All the other games were games, but cricket was an emotion to me. Now I would like to introduce you all to the president of Central Delhi Toastmasters Club. He's a passionate Toastmaster and a passionate problem solver. He's always ready to help the club members and leads the club through his own example. He's currently working as the consultant to Government of India in NITI Aayog. He is a man of words. Please back me welcome the president of Central Delhi Toastmasters Club, Toastmaster Kartik Bhatia.
Thank you, Kashish, for that great introduction. Before we move ahead, I would request you all to please close your eyes and pray for world peace for 30 seconds and also pray that this tragedy of a pandemic gets over very quickly. Right. Thank you, everyone. First of all, I would like to thank everyone in the club who inquired about my well-being. Yes, I am not fully well yet, but I'm on the road to recovery. And hopefully I'll be back with my strength, full strength next week. But I'm extremely thankful to the Toastmaster community who helped arrange oxygen cylinders and other things, especially Gur Sifat name I would like to mention, and as the entire community of the club who helped me in these times. Today I want to talk about really not giving up. I mean, we totally understand that things aren't good around us, but people have come together and we are not quitting. And one such story is of an avid mountaineer called Aaron Ralston. In 2003, he went hiking in Utah's canyon. He didn't tell anyone where he was going. While climbing, he lost his grip and he fell, knocking a boulder which trapped his right hand and his wrist against the wall. Aaron attempted to move the boulder, but it didn't budge. He called for help, but realized that he was alone. He also started to chip away parts of the boulder with a pocket knife, and he also began recording his audio on a camcorder he had. On the next 5 days, he rationed his food and his remaining 150 ml of water. He struggled to keep warm at night. He also set up a pulley using his climbing rope to lift the boulder, but it was a futile attempt. Throughout the days while he was stuck, he became desperate and depressed and began hallucinating about escape, his relationship, and his family. He realized that his actual mistake was that he did not tell anyone where he was going and for how long he was going. Then on the sixth day, using a tube installation and a carabiner that he had, he broke the bones in his arm. And using a multi-tool that he had, he amputated his arm. And once he was free, then back in the desert, he spotted a family on a hike and he called for help. The family gave him water and they alerted the authorities. The highway patrol police then took him to a hospital in the helicopter. Now, why is the story of Aaron Ralston important for us? It is very important because he never quit. Yes, tragedy strikes, and often not due to fault of our own. So rather than being stuck as helpless and hopeless in the face of calamity, if we have the will to survive and thrive, then we come out as a winner. The story of Aaron Ralston shows us that you never fail until you quit. Thank you. Well, at this point, I would like to acknowledge the presence of dignitaries. We have the immediate past international president, DTM Deepak Menon with us, and he is also a member of our club. We welcome you to the club, sir. At this point, I would like to talk to all the guests that have joined us today. Beginning with, let's talk to guest Anubhav Chaudhary. Guest Anubhav, please turn on your video. Kindly introduce yourself and let us know how did you get to know about our club. Guest Anubhav.
Hello.
Yes, Anubhav, we can hear you.
Hello. Hi, Anubhav this side. Hello.
Yes, Anubhav, kindly introduce yourself.
I am a student of Faculty of Law due first year and I am preparing for UPSC. I got recommended you from FISA.
All right, great, great. We welcome you to our club, Anubhav.
Okay, thank
Next up, I see. Thank you. Next up, I see guest Animesh Karg. Guest Animesh, kindly introduce, turn on your video, please. Introduce yourself and let us know how did you get to know about our club.
Hi, my name is Animesh and I am a filmmaker. I got introduced to Toastmasters by my father, who is also a part of this call.
All right, great. Now, well, we welcome you to our club and now let's talk to your father, Siddhant Karg. Guest Siddhant Karg.
Hi, good evening. This is Siddhant Karg. I was introduced to Toastmasters about 7-8 years ago by a friend from Dubai called Alex Thomas. So we found out that you had these programs happening in YMCA, but then somehow we were never able to make it to the Tuesday meetings of YMCA. So because over the weekend, you know, it struck me that we have the lockout and we have a good time to interact, to find out what else we can do to enhance our communication skills. So that's how the name of Shipra, her colleague, you know, who with whom I had spoken about 2.5 years ago. So I called her up and then she introduced me to you. So I'm happy to be here. So I look forward to see how it can help, you know, me and my son, because enhance our communication skills. And that's it for my side.
We welcome you to our club, sir. We'll definitely have a great experience today. Yeah. Next up, I see guest Rishita. Rishita, please turn on your video, introduce yourself, and let us know how did you get to know about our club. Guest Rishita.
Hello, everyone. My name is Rishita. Hi. I'm a first year student, and I'm pursuing in clinical psychology from Amity University, Noida.
Great. We welcome you. Next up, I see Rupal Jain. Rupal, please turn on your video. Introduce yourself, please.
Yeah. Myself, Rupal Jain. I'm currently pursuing MBA from Lal Bahadur Shastri Institute of Management, Delhi. And I got to know about the Toastmasters from a friend of mine who joined the Hyderabad chapter a year back.
Great, great. Great to have you in our club today, Rupal. Next up, I see guest Sujay. Sujay Joseph. Joseph?
Sujay, Hi, Karthik. I'm Sujay Joseph, and I'm working in an organization called Butterflies. It's a child rights organization, and I'm into communications and fundraising there. And since it's an NGO, I'm into in communications, meeting people, making presentations about our work, about our impact with impact with children, no? To international as well as in national funders. So I need to improve my in communication skills, and I learned about Toastmasters. I mean, like, and like it was a Google search, and also a Facebook search basically. And in the past, like, I was aware of Toastmasters, of course, but. I didn't, you know, get the time to physically come to the meetings. Like,
please take care of yourself.
Lockdown and all.
No worries.
And the lockdown and all here, and like it's all in work from home. So I thought I better go. And in most of my meetings are held online now. So I thought I can join now.
Yes.
Yeah, that's
right. Now
we
are online because of the pandemic. It's great to have you in our chat today. All right.
Yeah, thanks.
Next up, I see Shekhar, guest Shekhar. Please turn on your video, unmute yourself, and introduce yourself.
Hello, everyone. My name is Shekhar. I'm a software engineer, and I'm from Assam. Like, I'm currently based in Gurugram. Like, I heard about Toastmasters from I heard about Toastmasters from my sister. Like, she's currently studying in DU. Thank you.
Nice, great. Great. We welcome you to our club, Shekhar. All right. I see last guest, it's Tarun Nanda. Tarun, please unmute yourself, turn on your video, and introduce yourself, please.
Hi, a very good evening to all the Toastmasters. My name is Tarun. I'm a self-practitioner chartered accountant. I had attended few sessions of Toastmasters last year. So I come to know about the Toastmasters through one of the public speakers, that Darren Tay. So I'm really very impressed with his speaking. He's an ex-Toastmaster. So the motive of joining Toastmasters is to learn strategic communication skills as well as leadership. So that's all. Yeah, thank you.
All right. Great. It's great to have you here in our club today, Tarun. To all the guests that are attending the session today, please ensure that you attend the session for full 2 hours to understand what actually Toastmaster does. And every single segment has its own characteristic of adding to your capability of enhancing public speaking. And especially look out for a special session called as Table Topics Session. Toastmaster Darshan will be conducting that session. It is open to guests as well. So please volunteer to speak in that session and you'll have a great experience. All right, so thank you to all the guests that have joined in today. Please stay attentive and look out for the Table Topics. Now, without any further ado, I've spent a lot of time today. I'm speaking after a lot of time. Let's call upon the host of the meeting today, the Toastmaster of the day, Toastmaster Kashish, with his theme, Cricket, the Game of Happiness. Cricket, the Game of Happiness, by a Toastmaster of the day, Toastmaster Kashish Jain.
Hey, everyone. Good evening to all the fellow Toastmasters and the dear guests. My dear friends, I request you all to please turn on our videos, because this meeting is going to be a very interesting and a very interactive one, which will require your active participation. So I'm giving you 10 seconds for it. Please show your lovely faces and cherishing smiles. Great. Okay. Answer me one thing. Are you all ready to to play an exceptional innings in this meeting of Central Delhi Toastmasters Club. If you are ready, then when I will ask, how's the Josh? You have to reply, hi sir. When I will ask, how's the Josh? You have to reply, hi sir. Unmute yourself and show your energy. Let's begin. How's the Josh?
Hi sir.
Hi, sir. Energy. Hi,
sir. Full on Josh.
Hi, sir.
Hi, sir.
Hi, sir.
Great. Now you all seems to get enter into this game of emotions, happiness, enthusiasm, and whatnot. If you are an Indian, you must know that cricket is celebrated as a big festival here. It is followed religiously. You know, some people do it like as if there is a cricket match. Especially India, Pakistan, they arrange big screens. All the family, friends, relatives gather at a place and sit to see that match live. And you know, they see their reactions. There are more than the players who are playing. Like if a batsman gets out of the opposite team, these two friends who are sitting here, they are like, yes! They think like this friend has bowled the ball and this one took the catch, an outstanding catch. While watching TV, they are shouting, come on! Come on! They think that Virat Kohli has a walkie-talkie with him and he can listen to them very easily. If a batsman hits a shot and the ball goes in the air, the voice is naturally coming from inside. Catch, 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 catch. Bro, what do you have to do? Enjoy the match. But no, that is why cricket is known as the game of emotions, happiness, excitement, enthusiasm, satisfaction, and whatnot. Hey, ladies and gentlemen, now I would ask you some questions regarding to this game to check your abilities. Are you ready for it? Are you ready? Yes. Great. Be an active participant. Okay. So, my first question for you today is, how many times India has won World Cup? Unmute yourself, raise your hands, and answer.
Three times.
Okay, I've got two answers, two and three, but no, only one is right. It is three because I have not mentioned that it was a 50-50 or 20-20. India has won it three times. My second question for the day is, it is only for our lovely ladies present here. So boys, don't take participation. Which IPL team has won the highest number of IPL trophies?
Is it Chennai Super Kings?
I think Mumbai Indians.
Are you a girl? I have. I have said only ladies. Okay. Any other? Only girls. Show up your enthusiasm. No one? Try? Just a try?
It's a place famous for vada paos.
Okay. I think so, you are right. Okay, now our boy which answered, it was true. That is Mumbai Indians. Come on, girls. Show some interest. Okay, now my third question. It is for everyone. My third question for the day is,
please tell me the ranking, the number one ranking of T20 World Cup, T20, 50-50 and Test match. Which team has the top ranking in all the formats? It is different every format. Anyone? Some cricket fans here? No one? Okay.
Can I?
Yeah, you should.
In the test matches, it is India. In the one day international, New Zealand. And T20 international, it is England, I think.
Wow, yay! One of our players. He's here. Okay, so my third, fourth question for today. Only a few people would like to answer it. Why China is not allowed to play cricket? Any try? Someone wants to try? Yes. Anyone?
I think because they don't have the capability and the coaching and the, you know, to...
Okay, yeah, you are also correct. But I have some different opinions. It is because it can be dangerous if China participates. If a batsman gets out, we will not able to understand it. They will come again and we will not able to recognize them. So that's why. Okay, that was a cheesy one. Sorry for that. So now moving forward to the most amazing part of the cricket. That is, do you know, cricket can also teach you the art of living life? Of course it can. As we all know, if a batsman has to play an exceptional innings and score a century, he must have to play each and every ball at its best. He has to leave the bouncers, defend the good land deliveries, which are the tough deliveries, tough balls. And at the same time, hit the strokes on the easy deliveries, just like full toss, half volley, and short pitch. So, it happens same in life. Time throws bouncers, tough situations, which you have to deal very patiently, very easy, very strongly, very strugglingly, and just wait for the time to come. Because a full toss or a half volley is around your corner. Remember, a great batsman is whom? It is a batsman who waits for his delivery, who plays on the merit and scores the runs on the bad balls. Just you have to wait for your time. Okay. So now coming forward to the structure of the meeting. We have four segments today, just like the four innings in a cricket match. Yes. And each and every innings has its own importance. So the first innings will be the prepared speech segment. Prepared speech segment. When you see a batsman batting on the screen, hitting sixes, boundaries, and batting at a rate of 10 per over, it amazes us. But have you seen the hard work behind it? The grueling efforts? No. The same is with the hardworking speakers here. They prepare the speeches 7 days ago and keep on rehearsing it, practicing just to add a cherry over it. Yes. And then they come to deliver an excellent speech. The second segment, that is a module segment. Each and every speaker has the desire to give an excellent speech. We all want to win the best speech contest, but due to lack in some of the elements, just like whether it be our body language, sound modulation, or hand gesture, etc., we fail to achieve our aspirations. But don't worry, we have planned a session for you, this module session. The DTM Shiv Priya will take and she will cover up all the things which requires to win a contest. So moving forward to the third segment, the third innings, which is the most exciting, most entertaining, most shivering, and the most participating innings. And this meeting helps, this session helps us in each and every phase of our life. For example, when we are found talking to another girl, so our girlfriend asks, what was it? So at that time, we have to give an impromptu to her, explain. At the time, we reach late to the office. We have to give an impromptu speech to the boss. Yes, it helps in each and everything, each and every phase. So I will recommend each and everyone to participate in this. And the guests are also allowed to participate. So it is my request to each and every guest, take a part in it and tell your experiences. Moving to the fourth last innings, which is a decider innings. For a team to win a tournament, what is the most crucial thing? It has to hold on its positive and work on the negatives. But who will tell what are their positives and negatives? That's where an evaluator comes into the role. Here in Toastmasters, we provide you experienced Toastmasters, which will give you valuable feedback so that you can apply and give the best speech next time. So listen to their each and every word carefully. Now, I would like to introduce you all to the pillars of our meeting, the auxiliary role players. So the first auxiliary role is Timer, which is being played by Toastmaster Fez. He is an engineer by education. When I asked him about how cricket is related to him, he says that cricket has been an emotion to him and the most unforgettable moment was 2011 World Cup win. So please welcome Toastmaster Fez, the Timer for today. The stage is yours.
Thank you, Toastmaster Kashish. Am I audible?
Yes, you are. Yes, you are.
Am I visible? Could you please confirm?
No, you are not visible. Is there any network issue?
No, nothing as such.
No issues, says we will continue towards you. Till that time, I should call the next role player. The next role player. Sure. The next auxiliary role, which is language evaluator. And it is being played by Toastmaster Tanvi. When I asked, Tanvi is working with Make My Trip and is a learning digital experience and experienced professional. When I asked her about the cricket, she said she's not a big fan of cricket, but she is fond of cricketers. She loves to watch TV with her family, and it makes a great bond. So please welcome Toastmaster Tanvi.
Good evening, fellow Toastmasters. I'll be playing the role of language evaluator for today, wherein I'll be evaluating on your language skills and urge everyone to use the English language as correct as possible. And now let me introduce the theme of the day, which is cricket, and which is definitely a game of happiness. It brings the ideal opportunity to settle back and share raw emotions of the game with our friends and family. Together, we can share the agony if our favorite players are getting out. And on the other hand, if our favorite teams win, there is real sense of victory. So with this note, I am moving on to introduction of the word of the day, which is gruelling. So gruelling, I have also written in the chat box its meaning and some sample sentences. It means tiring or exhausting or involving a lot of continuous effort. I would just give you all a hint so that you all memorize this word. Just imagine a gorilla who is running after you what would you do? You would run until and unless you get really tired. So just, this is a visual aid or a mnemonic aid for you all to remember this word. And I urge all the Toastmasters who would be speaking in the today's session to use this word as much as possible. All right, over to you, TM Kashish.
Thank you so much. Thank you so much. Please keep a check on your language. So coming towards the next auxiliary role player, that is Ruhi, Toastmaster Ruhi. She's playing the role of a counter in today's meeting. So please welcome Toastmaster Ruhi. The stage is all yours.
Thank you, Toastmaster Kashish. Good evening, Toastmaster and guest. We often use filler words like well, so, etc., or repetitive words in our speech. Filler word may help us in indicating that our speech is not complete, or it may give us time to think what to say next. But excessive use of them reduces our confidence and credibility. Imagine a coach giving speech just before a match to his team or player and using between every words. So here, what will happen is the constant filler will undermine his message. It is often found in studies that many a time speakers are not even aware of how often they use crutch words. To help you become aware, today, as our counter, I will note down the use of filler words, repetitive phrases, long and short pauses of each one of you, and will present report at end of the meeting. Like in cricket, batsmen practice very hard regularly to know when to avoid bouncer, leave outside off, or to leave difficult balls so that he gives his best performance during the professional match. Similarly, I believe that with practice, we can avoid using filler words, and this will increase our effectiveness as a speaker and as a leader. Good luck. Over to you, Toastmaster of the day.
Thank you. Thank you so much, Ruhi. Now I would like to introduce the next auxiliary role player. That is Toastmaster Fez. He's the timer of today's meeting. Welcome, Toastmaster Fez.
Thank you so much, Toastmaster of the day. I think there was some glitch with my previous system, so I changed my system. So good evening, fellow Toastmasters and dear guests. My name is Faiz Kamil. I am an engineer by education. So as Toastmaster of the day has already introduced the topic of the day, which is cricket. I think the most funny aspect about the cricket for almost all South Asians is that it is a game which we have inherited from our colonizers, and we have outperformed them since then in their own game. Today I'm playing an important role of a timer. Essentially, I will be restricting your time duration for a speech. The purpose of this drill is to enable you to speak in a concise and a short manner, which is again an important trait of a good and effective speaker. So without doing any further delay, let's go on a simple rules. So I have three cards here, green, yellow, red, in same order. So on for a speech segment icebreaker, I will show green card on a completion of 4 minutes, yellow on 5, red on 6. For a speech segment for other speeches, green on 5, yellow on 6, red on 7. For table topic speaker and auxiliary role player, I will show green on 1, yellow on 1 minute 30 second, red on completion of 2 minutes. For a speech evaluator, I will show green on 2, yellow on 2 minutes 30 seconds, and for red on 3 minutes. So you all are expected to complete and summarize your speech by the time I show you red card. So thank you and all the best, everyone. Over to you, Toastmaster of the day.
Thank you so much, Faiz, for telling your role so correctly. And I request each and everyone to please adhere to the time limits today, because each and every contribution counts. So next, move forward to the first segment, that is a prepared speech segment. So our first speaker will be Toastmaster Simran. She is currently pursuing psychology honors from Delhi University. When I asked her about cricket, she said that she loves to watch the matches of India and Pakistan. She is also a very good fan of cricket. Before inviting her, I would like to invite her evaluator, that is Toastmaster Nipun Ahuja. He is a mathematician teacher and loves to read the books on Advaita Vedanta. When I asked him about the cricket, he said that he used to play the cricket matches in his locality and he loves to watch cricket, mostly the World Cup matches. Please, I would like to invite Toastmaster Nipun Ahuja, the evaluator of Toastmaster Simran.
Thank you, Toastmaster. Good evening, fellow Toastmasters. Today, Toastmaster Simran Dua is giving her Level 2 Project 2 speech from path name Presentation Mastery. Her project has two purposes. The purpose of the project is for the member to present a speech on any topic, receive feedback, and apply the feedback to a second speech. And the second is the purpose of the speech is for the member to demonstrate that she has applied the feedback received from the speech. Timer, please note down the time for the speech is 5 to 7 minutes. All the best to the speaker. Back to Toastmaster. Thank you.
Thank you so much, Toastmaster Nipun. Now I would like to invite Toastmaster Simran, the first speaker of today, with a great round of applause. The stage is all yours, Simran.
Famous quote by Thomas Carroll: "Speech is silver. Silence is golden." Good evening, fellow Toastmasters and guests. Silence. It is the absence of noise or any other sound. Basically, it is when the people do not communicate with one another. Silence is the peace of mind and absence of distractions. It is the stillness of the contentment of life. It is a positive song. Silence plays a significant role in our life and it needs to be maintained at some points of time. In today's time, the people are involved in achieving their goals and are caught in keeping a pace with the human race. They are busy in the hustle and bustle of life. Nowadays, rarely it happens that the people take a pause and they introspect their actions. Rarely it happens that the people, they spend some time with their inner self. Noise has become a part and parcel of our life, something which the people feel without which they cannot start their daily routine. This is not at all a good sign. So I believe that silence is a virtue that needs to be maintained in order to enlighten our minds to give a great output. There's a famous quote, "Silence is true wisdom's best reply." So with this, I would like to state some of the benefits of being silent. First, silence can help to build concentration in our day-to-day tasks. It can help to increase focus and thus help to produce a great output. Second, silence can help to increase awareness about our own actions. When we take a pause and when we introspect on our actions, then we can make some improvement in our lives. Third, silence can help us to keep a calm. Nowadays, we have to manage some stressful situations in our life. Silence helps to manage the stress. Fourth, silence is very good for our physical well-being. It can help us to lower our blood pressure and can boost the immune system. Silence is also good for building up brain cells that help in greater learning abilities. So these are the benedictions of being silent. I remember a great story and I would like to narrate it in front of you all today. So once there was a farmer. He was working on his barn and he lost his most precious watch. It was his favorite watch. He searched and searched and searched, but in vain. he did not give up. He saw some boys playing near the barn. He asked them for help. He just told them that they would get a reward in return. And hearing this, the boys, they just rushed to find the precious watch. They also searched for a long period of time, but in vain. Many of them gave up and went home. Seeing this, the farmer also lost his spirit. He also was about to go home when suddenly a boy came and asked him for a second chance. The farmer readily agreed. He just gave him the chance. And the boy, he returned with his watch in a few seconds. The farmer was delighted. He was a little curious as well. He asked him, "How did you manage to find my watch?" The boy replied, "I just sat in the barn in silence. It was much easier to hear the ticking of the watch when I was silent. And then I directed my search in the direction of the watch." The farmer gave him the reward. "Remember, when you are quiet, the more you can hear. Silence is very necessary to be maintained. Allow some moments of silence to your brain. And sometimes what you need to do is to just pause, relax, and listen." So with this, I remember a very great line: silence can yield more power than words. There was a famous quote by Leonardo da Vinci: "Nothing can yield as much authority than silence." So with this, I would like to explain some ways by which silence can yield more power. First, in order to build a relationship, trust is a very important component. So in order to build trust, listen to the people and give them an opportunity to speak. Second, and thus it would help to increase your power. Second, negotiate. Silence can be nerve-wracking while negotiating. It can turn and twist the tables. When you are silent, it would seem as if you are in deep thought. So your power would be increased. Third, empower others. Give others the opportunity to listen and to express themselves. You will gain respect. And thus, your power would increase. So these are the ways by which silence can help to build strength and increase your power. So now I would like to share one of my own personal experience with you all. So during my school days, I was considered one of the quietest girls in my class. I was the one who used to stay very quiet, and the people used to usually think that I'm really dumb. I don't know anything. And I just don't know anything. And then I used to feel that, why do people think like this about me? And it was not at all true. And it was just a phase of my life. But then I did not say anything to them. I just stayed focused and just did my job. I just worked very hard. Then there was an exam and I scored the highest marks in my class. And everyone was shocked. From my classmates to my teachers, everyone was like, how could I, being the quietest girl, get so many marks? And thus, I proved them wrong. So just by being silent, focusing on my goal, and just doing my job, and through my actions. So it proves that silence can speak when words can't. So I would like to conclude by saying that let silence be the art you practice, and silence is your strength. Thank you. Over to Toastmaster of the day.
Wow, what an amazing speech. A big round of applause. I would like to request each and every member to please unmute yourself and give a big round of applause to her. Oh, what a speech. We got to know the importance of the silence. Now I would like to give 20 seconds for the feedbacks, because feedbacks are the most important part of your journey. So please give feedbacks to Toastmaster Simran.
All right. It was absolutely a great speech, Simran. And almost everyone... Hello?
Yeah, I'm saying, Sanvi, you can give the feedbacks in the chat box.
Okay.
Yes. Please give the feedbacks in the chat box. Now, moving forward to our second speaker, whose name is Toastmaster Priyadarshini. She is a teacher by profession, and she has been a part of InSteel Toastmasters Club for past 2 years. When I asked her about cricket, she said that she is not a cricket fan, but she is amazing in board games. She likes to play chess, she likes to play Ludo and all the board games. And I was like, yes, this talent I also need because of the current scenario. Okay, before inviting her, I would like to invite her evaluator, who is Toastmaster Gosifat Kaur Sabra. She is the immediate past president. She's an amazing speaker and has a lot of energy. She's always ready to help the club members. I would request Toastmaster Gosifat Kaur Sabra to come and tell the pathways all of the speech.
Thank you so much, Kashish. Good evening, fellow Toastmasters and dear guests. Toastmaster Priyadarshini is delivering her Project 3 speech from Level 1. Her pathway is innovative planning. The purpose of the project is for the member to learn or review basic research method and present a well-organized, well-researched speech on any topic. The time allotted is 5 to 7 minutes. All the best to the speaker. Over to the Toastmaster of the day.
Thank you so much, Gursifat. Now, I would like to invite Toastmaster Priyadarshini with her topic, The Pathbreakers. Toastmaster Priyadarshini with her topic, The Pathbreakers. The stage is all yours,
Priyadarshini. Just give me a moment. Good evening, fellow Toastmasters and dear guests. The history of mankind is replete with various path-breaking inventions that have brought about immense change in our entire lifestyle. These path-breaking inventions have crept so deeply into our lives that they have become a part of our lifestyle and we do not have enough of them. But today, when you look at my topic, if you're looking forward to some greatest inventions of all times, then let me tell you, you are going to be disappointed. Because today, I do not have something very great or something very important, something that we consider very important in our normal day-to-day life. Today, I have with me my 5 dear little friends, without whom our lives would be unimaginable. Therefore, it is my urge to all my fellow dear Toastmasters and friends who are present in this meeting, utilize these 5 to 7 minutes of their time to appreciate these small little things that make our lives very, very simple. My first friend is the safety pin, which is probably every individual's best friend. Do you have any idea how the safety pin that we know of today came into existence? Well, the entire credit goes to Mr. Walter Hunt. But do you know how Walter Hunt invented the safety pin? Well, you will be surprised to know that Walter Hunt invented the safety pin to pay off his $15 debt that he owed his friend. He took a brass piece, which was 8 inches long, and folded it, give it a shape of a clasp. Then he sold this invention to the W.R. Grace and Company for an amount of just $400, of which he paid off his debt of $15 and kept remaining $385 for himself. But what Walter Hunt did not know was that the W.R. Grace Company is going to make millions with his invention. The safety pin holds a very important position in our society. It has also become a tradition in the Indian society where a family pin is handed down from generation to the next generation. Safety pins are also a medical concern. There have been cases in several countries where small children have swallowed a safety pin. Therefore, the safety pin advises you all use it safely so that it does not become an unsafety pin. My next friend is the comb. Well, each one of us are so very close to our comb because we love to decorate our beautiful locks with this comb, with the comb. Well, the inventor of a comb is not known to the world. However, the existence of combs date back to prehistoric times. The earliest mention of the combs have been found about 5,000 years ago. So the ones, these pictures that you see, these are the different types of combs that are some of the different types of combs which existed. On this side, you see a pineta. A pineta is a type of comb which is used in Spain to keep the mantilla in place. A mantilla is basically a veil that is worn by the women in Spain on the special occasions. Let's move on to the next object, which plays a very, very important role in our life. And that is the Band-Aid. Well, the story behind the invention of the Band-Aid is very, very different. It was accidentally invented by Mr. Earl Dixon, who took a piece of cotton and a tape to dress the wounds of his wife, Josephine. Well, he was then working with the company named Thomas Anderson and Johnson and Johnson, the name which was there previously for the company, which we now know as only Johnson and Johnson. Well, when he had this idea, he felt it was easier for him to dress the wounds without any help from anybody else. Hence, he put forth his idea to his employer, Johnson and Johnson, and thereby it led to the mass production of the Band-Aids, earning Mr. Dixon a very good position in the company. He retired from the company as its vice president in the year 1987. However, the Band-Aids that were made initially were handmade and were not much in sale. However, the sale of these Band-Aids increased in the year 1924 when machine-made Band-Aids came to the market, which was furthered with the invention of sterilized Band-Aids in 1939. In the year 1959, Johnson & Johnson came up with the idea with the theme-inspired Band-Aids, which featured the Mickey Mouse, Donald Duck, Barbie, Dora, etc. And now, in present day, we have Band-Aids which actually suit the size of our wounds. So this is the greatness. This is the story behind the Band-Aid that we have now. The next feature, next on my list, is a stapler. Well, when you Google what is the definition of a stapler is a mechanical device that joins the pages of paper of the similar material. In the 19th century, we saw an increase in the use of paper. Therefore, it was in the year 1866 when one Mr. George McGill received the US patent number 56587 for a bendable paper fastener that is a precursor to the modern stapler that we use. It was in the year 1941 that the type of staple that is commonly used today found its way into our lives, which is popularly known as the four-way stapler. This prototype of the four-way stapler has been modified and best suited to staple pieces of paper or sheets or wood, etc. The last fan on my list is the hole punch, which we lovingly call as the punching machine or the punch machine. Well, the single hole punch precedes the multiple hole punch that we have nowadays, and it origins back to Germany, where it was first patented by Mr. Frederick Sonneken. It was in the year 2017 when Google released a doodle celebrate 131 years of this tool. Let us take some time to appreciate all these little things that are around us and put some effort to realize how easy they have made our lives. With this, I would like to thank you all. Over to the Toastmaster of the day.
Thank you so much, Priyadarshini. Wow, again a wonderful speech. These two speeches were phenomenal. I would like to give us anyway. Now, please give the feedbacks to them. I'm giving you 20 seconds for it. Please give the feedbacks, because feedbacks are the backbone for any Toastmaster to improve. Each and every feedback counts. I'll request the tech master to please raise the ballots for best speaker. We have two speakers today. The first one was Toastmaster Simran Dua, and the second one was Toastmaster Priyadarshini Sengupta. Please vote. Each and every vote counts. Please vote. Okay, now moving forward to our second segment, second innings, that is being conducted by Toastmaster Shivpriya Ma'am. Toastmaster Shivpriya Ma'am is a talent and change consultant with over an experience of 7.5 years. She has been the part of Toastmasters Club over 5 years. She has won District 91 Humorous Speech Contest, and she was the finalist of District Level Table Topic Contest. She has a lot of content today. She will give a great content to you. Please help me welcome Toastmaster Shivpriya Ma'am for conducting an amazing session. Over to you, Shivpriya Ma'am.
Thank you very much, Mr. Toastmaster of the day. First and foremost, I am not a ma'am, especially not when I have distinguished Toastmaster Deepak Menon sitting in the room. Secondly, even if he wasn't sitting in the room, please do not call me ma'am. My name is Shivpriya. It's a lovely experience. It's great sitting at CDTM. CDTM has its own legacy. CDTM has been a club which everybody would like to visit. And I specifically know, because I used to travel to CP just so that I could visit CDTM and I could meet the members. So thank you so much for inviting me. Secondly, I'm going to talk about Lord of the Rings today. A lot of you must be wondering that, why is she talking about Lord of the Rings? I thought there was a clear-cut agenda, but nobody mentioned what I need to speak about. So I'm going to be speaking about Lord of the Rings. So how many of you know Lord of the Rings? So can you just give me a raise of hand so I could see one, two, three. Wow. Three of you out of 30. Four. Thank you so much, our counter. So do we have some more people? Great. That is rule number one. If your key takeaway is only addressing 4 out of 30 people in the audience room, then that's not the key takeaway you would like to give to your audience. So relief, a sign of relief for everybody, it is not going to be on Lord of the Rings. So that is to start, to begin with, what you need to speak about. I would want you to quickly write your expectations in the next 10 seconds and just mention it on a chat window. What is that you have been expecting out of this session? Hopefully not about Frodo Baggins. And in case if you can turn on your camera, that would be amazing. Because if I sense that you are getting bored, then I can quickly change the subject. How to craft a captivating speech. Thank you, Karthik, for sharing that. Anyone else with any expectations at all? How to craft a perfect speech. Lovely. Thank you, Gursifat. Gursifat, am I correct?
Yes, you are.
Thank you. How to deliver a speech with confidence. Great. Some tips for writing. Start writing a speech. Lovely. How to find the right topic. It has always been a trouble. Okay. So how many of you actually got confused in terms of should I choose the key takeaway first or the message first, or should I choose the story first? How many of you have actually faced this problem? Yes, no, probably, maybe, true. Now, tell me something. If I already decide what I'm going to speak on, would you ever feel that my stories are actually force-fitted? So tell me something. So do you decide today that today I'm going to learn about time management and I'm going to work this, or I'm going to experiment and I'm going to learn that this is what I do not have to do? Is that how you learn time management? Or do you practice, make mistakes, do some right things, and then you learn about time management? How do you do it? Do you do things first or do you learn things first? Just put your response in the chat. If you feel that you learn things first and accordingly you do, that's also all right. Thank you, Kashish. It will also be voice modulation. Great. So do you do things first or do you learn things first? And we are talking about learning by doing. Do things first. Okay. Do and learn and make improvements. Thank you, Rupal. Learn things first. Thank you, Sagar. Okay, learn things first. Okay, so I'll tell you something very interesting, which my teacher once told me, and it might be a very cliched sentiment or a cliched statement, and it's a sentiment because she told me with a lot of emotions. She said, like, life is a teacher, or it's an examination which conducts the test first and the learnings later. Have you ever heard of this? And as adults, do you really open your book and read how life lessons should be? Or do you practice them, experiment them, and then you learn things? Give me your response in case if you practice first. Thank you. And I'm going to keep it very, very conversational. This is not going to be a speech demonstration and say that you learn out of it. So I'm just going to keep it very conversational. In case if you want to unmute yourself, please do that. I would love that. Learn, make mistake, learn. Lovely, Pooja. Anything, do you have any perspective, Gajendra? Do it, fall in it, learn from it. Thank you. Interesting. All right, so far I'm getting a trend.
You have to speak from the heart, I think. If you want to make an impact on a speech, then you must know the topic, which is very close to it.
I'm not even talking about speeches. Let's forget about speeches. I'm not even writing a speech right now. Right now, I'm thinking about, do I decide what I need to tell the audience, or do I decide from where I need to tell the message? So very simple. A lot of times when I was writing my ISC speech, and I've never cleared ISC beyond area, but this is something which I have analyzed from greater speakers. It is never decided what you want to say in terms of the message. Because the minute you decide the message, your story will be a force fit. And somebody who's smart will understand that this person wants to say that you wake up early, and the person is just using different stories as a logic to just give a reasoning or give a situation, give a logic to it. The minute you are sensing a logic which is reverse, that's when you lose your audience. Are you with me? If I say that you have to wake up early, and once upon a time I slept late, and I slept late, I woke up late, I lost this opportunity, the minute you will say that, hey, you've already told me what you want to tell me, or the entire situation is force fit. So never try to force fit. First and foremost, understand or introspect. Do you have any situation in your life or any experience in your life from where you got a profound learning? If yes, that's your story. If not, do not try to give any random story and try to force fit, because I want to share this message that believe in people. So never force fit your anecdotes. Never force fit your supporting stories. Always try to find out, what did this experience teach you? And if this experience teach you, that is what you need to tell the audience. So far, are you with me? Anybody? Diverse thoughts? I'm more than happy to have diverse thoughts. Deepak, sir, maybe?
Well, we do that in table topics, don't we? Where a message is provided to us and then we force fit an anecdote to it.
Very true. Mm-hmm. And how very, very true. And I like diverse thoughts. Reason being, like, the minute you put as a table topic, the audience does not know what, and the audience loses the surprise of what is that am I going to get out of it. So the audience already knows, right? This is the key message I'm going to derive. So the only thing which you're providing the audience is with the story, so that you're able to engage the audience for 2 minutes. But that surprise element is gone. In an ISC, you provide them with a call for action. That call for action will be lost the minute you have you decide your call of action, and then you say that, okay, let me force fit it. So far, are you with me? Perfect. Second, when you write your speech, how do you place yourself? And it's very important. And I'll tell you where I'm coming from. There was this workshop I attended, and all my learnings are from different speakers. None of them are my own. So I would not like to take any of the credit of my own content. They are learned from the most amazing speakers, and they are probably articulated in the worst way possible. I'm so happy that these speakers are not in the room. Otherwise, they would have said, shift here. This is not how I explained. So coming back to the learning which I've got, I need to be not the hero of my story. How many of you understand this concept of not being a hero? Anybody who did not understand this? Pooja, Rupal, Akriti. All right, Akriti decided. Okay, Akriti, thank you, Akriti. Why don't you unmute yourself and probably say that what makes you not get that? Or
I did not understand what actually do you imply by not being the hero of your story, because when you speak a story or when you narrate a story, you as a speaker, you expect that you at least are playing the best and you're taking the best out of that story so that you can convey the same to the audience.
Perfect. Thank you. Pooja, your thoughts?
Same logic. I'm sure that you must be having some story behind what you said, but same layman logic that when you are narrating something or it's your story, you would expect yourself to be the hero of the story. So why would someone say that you're not supposed to be the hero of your story? So that's interesting, and we would like to listen more about it.
Thank you so much, Pooja. Pooja, the minute somebody said, right, Shivpriya has done this, Shivpriya has done that, the first thing which I generally see in people's faces is, oh my God, okay, wow, she's probably done so much. And the second thing is that, okay, that's Shivpriya and that's not me. the minute you're the hero of the story, you detach with your audience. Why is that? You get connected to your audience in a short span of time when you show your side of vulnerability. The minute you're the hero of the story, the opportunity to be vulnerable gets lost. And let me explain it to you where I came from. There was a person who was a topper in my class, and he had always been the topper in my class. Every single time he gets 100 out of 100, every single time he's the one who's been appreciated by the teachers and the principal. The person was never on the top of my list to be friends. Simple, he does not understand my struggle to get a score of probably 100, not even 100, probably of 75. I am not a distinction student. I barely passed my undergraduate. And when I did, I could never appreciate a topper because that is not someone who's Shivpriya. And secondly, every single time I had probably a context or I was intimidated by him that I never really shared my vulnerability with him. Now, everybody has some or other areas of development. Everybody has their own strengths, but everybody also has some kind of limitations. Now, if I say, hi, I'm Shivpriya. At the age of 15, I got a Nobel Prize. At the age of 17, Microsoft hired me. At the age of 18, Jack Welch wanted me to be his mentor. You'll say, Shivpriya, I'm not you. Tell me something which I can connect to. Every time when you're trying to be humorous, the best humor is self-deprecation, right? Why does it work? Because the person shows their vulnerability. The person laughs with you. The person allows the audience to laugh at him with him or her, right? The minute you show your vulnerability, people will say that if Shivpriya can learn, why not me? If Shivpriya was so good, I do not want to listen to her story. If Shivpriya is someone who I can connect to, probably I want to know more about her. So if in my story, I was the one who was the magnanimous one, I was the one who was generous, I was the one who gave everybody the right path to, you know, follow, then I am not like the audience. How many of us are coaches? How many of us are perfect doers, perfectionists? How many of us are like super successful? Not many, right? Think about it. Even in the world of 3.58 lakhs people in the world, how many of us are world champions? None of us. So if I say that, hey, I'm a world champion, you're less than a person. You do not represent the maximum of the population. So when you talk about your accomplishments, when you talk about how amazing Shivpriya is, I lose my audience automatically. Shivpriya needs to be somebody who's like you. Shivpriya is someone who makes mistakes. Shivpriya is someone who learns after her mom's chuckles, like a lot of other things which my mother throws at me. Shivpriya is somebody who learns like you. The minute you become the hero of your story, the audience will lose you. The minute you say that you're a part of the audience, you're a commoner just like the audience, you are someone who learns like the audience, who makes mistakes like the audience, you suddenly connect. The funniest part is that when I was trying to do a speech, a humorous speech in another district, the only thing which connected with the audience was, hey, you got rejected by a guy. Even I got rejected by a fellow Toastmaster. And today we became very good friends. The person did not look at whether I won the area. The person looked at, hey, you got dumped, so did I. So a lot of times when people have common weaknesses or common failures, they connect with you faster. So when I say do not be the hero of your story, do not try to put the hero as someone who has superpowers, who gets the girl, who gets the guy, who is probably the magnanimous one, who's rich like Batman, who's a philanthropy like everybody. Do not make yourself as a Superman of your story. Make yourself as a commoner who learns from the story. So far, are you with me? And somewhat, do you agree with me, Pooja? And Akriti, somewhere, do you agree? Are you getting what I'm trying to say?
Oh, yes, so far? Absolutely.
Thank you. Number three, when you're writing a speech, it is not the final draft. It is probably the first draft of 500 drafts. And I'll tell you why I say that. When you write from your first perspective. You write for yourself. You try to write what happened. It is more like a reporting or way of writing your data analysis, right? But this information needs to be articulated for someone else who does not know about this data. A lot of times you know what has happened in your life, so you do not even have to give a context, right? You know this was a train journey which you took with your father and you were going supposed to go to the destination, and you learned in your train journey that you're always about the destination, not about the journey, and your father gives a whack and he teaches you that, Shiva, what are you doing? You're not even appreciating what is around you. And you are so angry, later you realize my father was right. Okay. Nobody knows what happened in the train journey. It's in your head. Does the audience even understand the importance of this particular train journey in your life? Does the audience even understand the purpose of your train journey? Does the audience understand your relationship with your father or how you are? A lot of times these minor things might be amiss, and that's why audience may not be able to connect with you as you're able to connect with the story. So your first draft is always for yourself. Do not go and give this draft to, or do not even use this draft to give the speech. First draft, just write it down. Sleep on it. Take 2 days. Next time, just listen to it or read it as a third person. When you read it as a third person, you will understand that this is not making sense. They do not know which seat I was in or what's the importance of me taking a window seat. When you read it from a third person, you understand the misses. Your first draft is all about ethos. It's all about, say, it's all about pathos. It's all about passion, emotion. You just are putting your heart out. Your later drafts talks about your logos. Is there logic? Is there something that ties the entire story together? Am I missing on important points? And when you're delivering this, you try to understand, am I articulating the right thing? Am I making sense by stating the story? Do you think if I stand and deliver the story, Karan will learn something from this? Do you think that Priyanka would feel that she has invested 5 minutes of her life listening to the story and she got something out of it? And that's where your ethos come in. So first and foremost, be passionate about what you're writing. Secondly, look at it from a third person's perspective. Look at it in a detached way so that you could see that there is logic. And as a third person, am I getting all the information I need so that I can follow your story or your speech? And third, does it make sense for distinguished Toastmaster Deepak Menon to sit through my speech? Or will he feel that it's 7 minutes of my time, which I'll never get back? Think about it. Because you are speaking for your audience. You might be speaking your story, but you're speaking for the audience. If there is no key takeaway, you're actually wasting 30 people's, if I'm one person, and okay, I'm really poor at mathematics. So I'm just going to assume that 30 into 7, which is 210, minus 7, which is 203 minutes of time wastage, which is happening right now, if I give a 5 to 7 minute speech, and it is of no use. Number 4. So far, are you with me, everybody? Decide on what is that. So I'm just going to give a quick recap. First and foremost, identify that profound moment in your life and what you learned about it. That's your story. Don't say that, oh, everybody's talking about bullying. Let me also talk about bullying and try to force fit a story. No. Decide what you learned from your experience and then share that experience. Second, please do not be the hero of the story. Be someone everybody can relate to. If you're the hero of the story, you'll just be like the topper. Everybody was, wow, what a topper. But nobody would want to be your friend. And it's all about moving people. It's not about impressing people. Number 3, your first draft is never the final draft. I know there are only 2 versions of the story which is created, and probably there's just a grammatical, you know, changes which people do. If you want to write a great story, write it with passion, QC, or the quality check it with logic, and check for that ethics, that key takeaway. that value you're giving to the audience. You're speaking for the audience. You're not speaking for yourself. You're speaking from yourself, but for the audience. So far, are you with me? Great. Number four, how many of you are a fan of great words? Amazing vocabulary. A lot of us, okay. Karthik, even so did I. So I first thing I do is go to thesaurus, try to look the most impressive word of all time. I mean, I practice 20 times the pronunciation because I don't even know how to pronounce. So, but I want to impress people. Hey, I have Deepak Menon in the room. I have to use the big words, right? But guess what? How many of them are Deepak Menon? Apologies, sir. I'm just using your example. But how many of them are Deepak Menon? There could be a Shivpriya sitting who does not understand the word. Are you trying to express one person in the audience, or are you trying to impress one person in the audience, or are you trying to express to 100% of the audience members? We have an obsession with big words because it's not because of Toastmasters. That's just how we have been brought up. Our every essay in our college, our every debate in our schools, they want profound, those thesaurus, you know, those words coming out of thesaurus. And I know, I have done, opened the dictionary. I didn't even know the meaning, but I have actually marked up so that I can give a debate, speech the next day. But that is not going to express what you want to do. What if there is one person in the room? Everybody understands, Shafia doesn't understand. Your entire 5 to 7 minutes is a waste for her. So please do not be insanely attached to those big words. Keep simpler words, because that is what is going to help you communicate what you want to do. Number five, a lot of you talked about vocal variety, right? How do I bring voice modulation? And I'm going to touch about delivery. Because once you have a great speech, it is like having a Ferrari in your garage. Unfortunately, you would want to drive it. That's how you make your neighborhood jealous, right? You have a great speech. You want to have a great delivery. Are you with me? How do you deliver a speech? Simple. There are three ways in which I have tried to deliver the speech, or I have tried to somewhat, I wouldn't even call master it, somewhat develop my delivery skills. When you're delivering a humorous speech, do it with the audience's audio and video on. I'll say audio because you need to understand what type of jokes they respond to well. If I hear a chuckle from Pooja, that means I need to put a pause in that segment. If I feel that this joke is going to be amazing and Deepak sir has a blank face, that means this joke is not working. I do not need a pause or probably change the joke. In case, if there is a joke and if you walk into a joke, and let's say there are some jokes which basically takes a lot of time for the audience to get, right? It can be very intellectual joke, or it can be a pun intended and people need a couple of seconds. And often what happens, I speak the joke and I don't give a pause and I move forward, okay? And I'm walking into a potential laughter. So a lot of times, give those pauses. Try to understand the psychology of the audience and accordingly you decide the delivery. In case if you do not have a Toastmasters meeting to go to and deliver, just ask your best friend who's a Toastmaster, your mentor, your VP education, they're always there to help you, or anybody. And try or practice a speech so that you understand what part of the speech is actually moving the person. And that's how you decide whether to keep a pause or not. Because most of the time, and I have made this mistake, I feel that this is the most important part of the speech, but there is no response from the people. And then I could say the silliest of things, and suddenly there's a high audience response. So if you're new to identifying, if you do not know what will fetch me a response, practice that with one or two Toastmasters, with diverse Toastmasters. If one of them is young and dynamic like Deepak Menon, then you can pick up someone like old and senile like me. So you can have diverse Toastmasters so that we you understand that how it affects or how it is absorbed by the audience. Once you do it, automatically your delivery will be there. Second, your vocal variety is driven by your emotions. If you're true to the story, it will naturally come. You do not need to orchestrate it. The minute you try to orchestrate a story, which is probably, you know, crafted, which is probably changed 25 times while you redrafted the story, it will be difficult. You cannot tell stories. You have been telling stories. Do you really think so, Pooja, that you went for every time you went out to meet your friend, you told your mother that you were going to meet your friend? Didn't you tell her that it's a study group? Didn't you say that you were planning to do a project work? We have been telling stories since our childhood. It's just we haven't been consciously telling our stories. Stories have been something which, even when you tell your best friend or recommend your best friend to watch a movie which you love, it's still a storytelling. You are trying to say it's just not your own story. So replace those characters with real characters and replace those incidents with your incidents. It becomes your personal story. Practice it. It's probably the best way of giving a speech. Because when you tell your stories, your audience do not know what you're going to talk about. If you talk about something, let's say, why we should drink water, Deepak sir will say that I've been drinking water since I was a kid. Okay, you don't tell me this. He will not say like that. He will think like that. But he will say that, thank you so much, Shiv Priya, for reminding us, because he's such a gentleman, but he's such a lovely Toastmaster. But he, in his mind, will say, Shiv Priya, I know this. See, he's drinking water. But when you say your personal story, Ankit will say, I did not know that. You did not know that, Ankit, because it happened with me. It happened in my life. It happened. You, nobody knows about this. Nobody is privy to the information. That's when I give a great surprise to my audience. That's the value addition I'm giving to my audience. So are you with me, Pooja? Will you promise to give some more stories for me? And I would love to listen to some of them. So coming back to emotions, when you tell your true story, you're reliving an experience. Keep it in your head. And when you think words, expressions don't come out. It's very important. Practice your speech so well that even if I wake you up at 3 a.m, you're able to say paragraph number 4 from line number 3. Practice your speech so that you don't have to consciously remember what emotion do I have to project. Practice so that you know the words. And when you're saying or speaking on the stage, you're reliving that experience. If you're talking about your rafting experience, I know when you sat on the first raft, you were scared. You don't have to orchestrate that expressions, right? If you were scared, you were scared. You don't have to change your vocal variety or change your facial expressions as per being scared, because you're reliving that experience. You're just reliving, articulating with thought out words. That's all you're doing. But when you change your story 10,000 times, and trust me, I have done this. Right before my division contest, I changed my story and it did not happen. Because it did not happen, my expressions were so confusing. And then 2 days before the contest, we went back to the original place where we went back to the story which actually happened. And I was able to relive. It's about being embarrassed. And frankly, I did not know how to be embarrassed because the story wasn't mine. Here, the story, I gave the same speech at CDTM. And I had told, like, there was a Toastmaster who I went and confessed my feelings in a 5 to 7 minute speech. And he rejected me in a 2 to 3 minute evaluation. So I knew how it feels. I was like, should I say that it's a great speech ever? It was an amazing speech, Shiv Priya. It's just, we can't be together. And it's a painful feeling. I do not have to recreate or create that expressions. I can just relive them. So vocal variety has to come from heart and not from mind. And the best way to practice your vocal variety as well as your facial expressions is to practice in front of mirror. If you find yourself authentic, the audience will. If you are yourself, you don't find it authentic and you feel that it is dramatized or it is artificial, you will not be able to convince yourself or the audience. Are you with me? Anybody? so far. Lovely. And my okay, bye. Okay, I guess, am I supposed to say bye because of to the bed? So can I just take one last minute? Thank you. I just have one point. Thank you. So coming back to the meeting, my only request to you, which is the final key takeaway, please practice. If you do not practice, if you do not practice with your heart, no matter how amazing speech you have written, no matter how amazing delivery you have planned, it will not come to reality. When I gave my final speech at the district level on May 2nd, which was a humorous speech contest, I knew every minute what is going to happen. I knew every minute how I'm going to present because I recorded myself. I knew what expressions I would give at what time. It wasn't artificial or crafted, but I was aware of it. So this is where you move. I was at the stage of conscious competence. So when I was at this stage of conscious competence, I knew how it's going to turn out. So practice, 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 practice. Before this, I had never crossed humorous speech beyond my club level. They had always kicked me out. They said, Shivpreya, you're not funny. I'm still not funny. I still give probably the worst jokes possible. You cannot put me on a stand-up comedy and say, hey, Shivpreya, you're funny. Nope. The audience will probably throw eggs and tomatoes, and I can actually open a small store. You know, I can actually open a counter because that's the amount of inventory they will throw at me. But I still got a chance to compete and win because I practiced. Practice, 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 practice. That is all I'm going to say. Everybody will have their own logic for structuring. Do not stick to one logic. Otherwise, everybody will be the same speech. So you all will be Marvel heroes. Use your own way or use your own methodology to structure. Every story has a different structure. You might have 90% of your story and 10% of your key takeaway. You can have 60, 40, 60, 20, 20. Practice is writing your speech, Pooja. Writing, redrafting, redrafting, redrafting till you're satisfied with it and delivering it every single day. If you want to be a champion, people have been practicing for 2 years. They practice the same speech for 2 years. And I'm not trying to exaggerate. You can ask Deepak sir and how long they have been practicing the same speech. Topic is yours, dear. It is your topic. If something happened profound to you the previous night, you can write about it. There was one world champion who actually talked about he learned the greatest life lesson while changing the car's tire. Changed by the tire, Press Vasilev, 2013. That's it. You do not even have to have a profound story that, oh my God, I had such a major issue and blah, blah, blah. You don't need to have a life-changing experience in terms of, you know, everything went off the heroic or the Bollywood way. You just need to have a simple experience. Yes, Mr. Timer, I got it. I will complete within 30 seconds. You do not have to show this. So the point is that you can pick up the smallest incidents which gave you the largest learnings. My biggest experience was when I went on a train journey with my father. I told him, oh my God, Dad, we are finishing. We are reaching. He said, guess what? It was a 2-night ride and you never even spoke to a single person. You're somebody who was so obsessed with the destination that you never enjoyed the journey. And nothing profound happened. I did not lose my father in the next compartment, or my father did not lose or miss the train while standing and buying me chocolates. Nothing happened. It was just a simple train journey. So simple things can actually give you a better learning because that's when everything is relatable. If I talk about my life-changing experience of how I overcame cancer, guess what? Probably not even one person of your audience must have done that. So keep it as simple as possible. But the learning has to be even simpler. But the learning from your topic has to be profound, or from the experience has to be profound. I hope you're with me. None of the WCPS champions gave you, wow, life-changing lessons. Everybody knows that you have to wake up 5 in the morning to do yoga. That will make you healthy. But it's all about how you say it. So with this, I complete my module. And before the timer says anything, if there is one last question, I would love to take it with timer's permission. And I hope you had learned something. I got starstruck because a star was sitting here, but I hope you had learned something out of it. In case if you have, great. In case if you haven't, it's just your 30 minutes of your life that you're not getting back. Thank you, Deepak, sir, for that confirmation. Any questions, anybody? Last question.
Since no one is asking, can I, instead of typing, I thought this will be quicker.
Okay, perfect. The timer will love you.
Okay, I know they're going to hate me. So thinking like when I speak, normally the feedback I've got from people is I don't have emotions. So when I talk or when I tell stories, like it could be my marriage story or my birthday, how I celebrated my birthday or how was my wedding day. So there will be no emotions in the speech. It'll be like flat.
When you're giving a speech, do you try to recall what's the next paragraph?
So what happens with me is when I try to talk or when I, suppose if I have, right now we are having a conversation, but if I have to speak for a minute or something, I go blank. There is nothing in my head. I don't know what to talk. I'm completely blank. So probably that, it's just, yeah.
Thank you so much, Pooja. I do not know the answer for this. So probably there's one recommendation or one suggestion which Deepak Justin, distinguished Toastmaster Deepak Justin, gave me. He said, like, Shivpriya, when I was facing the same issues, he said, Shivpriya, thinking in words, think in concepts, the words will automatically flow. What it means is that if I think in words, like how do I construct my sentence? What do I speak? If I say that, let me start with, you know, this word, or we have a habit of, you know, inserting word of the day and everything. And we've been playing on words. How do I construct my sentence? When I think words, or when I think what is the next paragraph, what is the first word of my next paragraph in a speech, I am not allowing my mind to experience the speech in the whole. So when you think concepts, for example, when a table topic is given, I think about an incident which happened rather than what to say. When I think about incident, I'm reliving. We all are proficient enough to convert that incident into words. Hence, we all are Toastmasters. But when we think about what right words to use, we lose the audience, we lose the topic, we lose the connect, we lose the emotions. So maybe try to think in concepts and not in words, and that will really help us to connect to the audience better. And maybe our mind will have less pressure because you're thinking about broader things. This has worked with me. Probably it will work with you. Thank you, Pooja. Yes. Yes, sir.
Another quick question. Suppose I'm making a speech. And I crack it.
Can I come back to you, Sujoy? I think Deepak sir had raised the hand first. I will come back to you as soon as Deepak sir said, and maybe if raising hands, that will work. Yes, sir.
Thank you, Shivpriya. I just wanted to add another piece of advice for Pooja, which is that when we're speaking to the audience, think of it as a conversation with the audience, because you're not just speaking, you're conversing. And when you think that you're conversing with the audience, it'll be the same experience as if you were conversing one-on-one with somebody else. So that's the way you need to treat it. If that's the concept that you have in your mind, you're going to do great.
So Deepak, can I speak for like few seconds? Mm-hmm. So Deepak sir, like what happens with me is even if I have to introduce myself or my brand or my label, like if I've been told, if I'm talking, having a conversation, it's fine. But the moment it's been told to me that I have to introduce or give a speech or talk about it for a minute or two, I don't know what happens. I'm completely like blank. And this has happened forever with me.
Well, you're in the right place. You're in Toastmasters. This is the place we come to get rid of that fear, that nervousness, and that challenge of how do we converse before an audience. So, you're going to get it.
I've attended 2 meetings as a guest and I've never ever participated in table topic.
Then that's what you should need to do. Right, sir? So this is the best platform where you could do something or where you can practice something which you're too scared of and nobody will say anything. Like I said, Deepak sir will be very kind and say that this is nice, Shivpriya, and he will not say anything else at all. So this is the best platform, Pooja. Thank you. Coming to Sujoy. Sorry, Sujoy.
Yeah, yes. No, that's okay. I just had a small clarification. If I'm making a speech, and I crack a joke in between, and you know, nobody laughs. Is there any escape strategy? I mean, it's a pretty embarrassing situation then.
Like, build a bridge and move on. Simple. That's all. Because if they do not laugh, if they do not laugh, it shouldn't come into your, it should not reflect in your face. A lot of times it does happen, right? Suddenly there's one person who in one club, it's a great joke and people like, wow, what a joke. Mm. And the next moment and everybody has a blank face that, oh, is it a joke?
It has happened with me.
Yes, it has happened with me also. It has happened with all of us, right? Even with the most funniest people on earth, on the face of earth, there will be one person who will not, you know, laugh at their joke or one set of audience. The quickest way is to forget and move on. Because if you're stuck there, it reduces your confidence for the rest of the speech, right? Yes, yes. So yes, then you will not be able to deliver the other jokes with a lot of passion and with a lot of enthusiasm, right? So the part is like, wait for 2 seconds, they didn't laugh, move on. Or you could just say, I was expecting a laugh, but nobody did. Out of pity, you could have laughed or something like that and just move on. And if it is a scripted speech, don't do that. Because if it's a scripted speech, then often your response can be out of nervousness. If you're in a stand-up comedy, you can maybe have an improv. But if it's a scripted speech, then you will think, oh my God, after this joke, I was supposed to start with this line. And suddenly when you're adding something, you forget the next line. And it has happened with me. I tried to do some improv and my coach said, like, don't do it. It is not your strength. So unless it's your strength, do not fall for it. Just move on. The audience did not laugh. Probably they'll find something else funny which you did not expect. So it's that's all.
Okay. Thank you so much. Thank you so much.
Thank you, Sujoy. So with that, I officially close my module. Sorry, timer, for taking a lot of time. Thank you so much, Mr. TMOD, for inviting me on stage. I request you to kindly take the stage back before I speak even more. Thank you. And it was a pleasure being at CBTM.
Wow. What an informative and phenomenal session it was. Honestly saying, Toastmaster Shivriya, you completely changed the atmosphere. All the guests and members would have got motivated. I am completely motivated and I will give a speech next time. In the next meeting, shortly.
Okay.
So, I'm sorry to all the members and the guests here because we are getting late at this moment. So, to cover up the time, we have to directly move to the evaluation session. But when I see the previous session, which was really engaging, very informative, this is worth it. So, now, moving forward directly to the evaluation session, I would like to call the general evaluator for today, who is Gajendra Khare. He is running his own HR consultant from 2013. And he enjoys to play cricket a lot when he was in his childhood. And now he's currently watching a lot of cricket matches. He's a fan of IPL. So, moving forward, please welcome the general evaluator for today, Toastmaster Gajendra Khare.
Thank you, Mr. Toastmaster. Am I audible and visible?
Yes.
Am I audible and visible? Yes, yes. Okay. So now we have come to a very important portion of the Toastmasters meeting. And this is extremely important. Why? Because it provides the speakers who gave a prepared speech or the prepared module. So we would provide tonight instantaneous feedback from the fellow Toastmasters member and for their improvement, hopefully. And my role as a general evaluator for today's meeting, first I would like to present the evaluator for the prepared speech, and then I will give my overall feedback about the meeting. So without any further ado, I would like to invite our first evaluator for today's first speaker, who was Toastmaster Simran. So may I request Toastmaster Nipun Ahuja to provide your evaluation for Simran's speech.
Thank you. Thank you. Good evening, General Evaluator and fellow Toastmasters. What a great speech Toastmaster Simran Dua has given. Her speech was well organized. She started her speech with quotation she used many quotations in between also, and she gave first very good definition of silence. Then she talked about benefits of silence. She told us about the story of farmer and boys, and there was moral behind it related to silence. Then she told about her own story, her personal example. She told about the ways of how we can improve the silence within us. And overall, I found that her speech was well organized and full clarity was there. She was always in eye contact with the camera or audience. Throughout her speech, she was able to develop interest among her audience. She was well aware of her audience and their receptibility. I found throughout her speech that she was comfortable, calm, and composed. I believe she has ability to be a good storyteller also, as she can grasp attention while telling story. Besides, good point in her speech, every speech has recommendation also. In her first speech, she was told to improve her voice modulation and gesture movement, and I will keep my recommendation also related to them. I found her voice was good and deep, but she was not modulating her voice much. If she can lift her voice during the start of the speech and while saying the quotation in between, she will improve her speech a lot. Also, while telling her story, if she can show emotions, like when she was telling the story of farmer and boys didn't get belonging at the first time after grueling search, then she should show the dejection of farmer. Also, when boys got the belonging second time, she could show the exuberance of the farmer. Similarly, she could show her emotions in her personal example when she didn't get good marks, and also when she got good marks after discovery of silence, she could show her happiness at that time. Also, if she could work on her gesture, I could see her hand moving, but they were not visible on camera, so she could see the adjustment of camera before her speech. And also she should take care of the movement of her body, because I feel that sitting at one position during her speech is not a good approach for good speeches. Overall, I found that her speech was very well composed, organized, full of quotations, and moral were there, and interest generating speech by the speaker. I give my good wishes to the speaker for more enthusiastic and energyful speeches. Back to General Evaluator. Thank you. You're not audible.
Okay. So thank you, Nipun, for the wonderful evaluation. So now I would like to invite the second evaluator, who is going to evaluate our second evaluator, Toastmaster Priyadarshini Saini. So Toastmaster Gursipa.
Thank you so much, Gajendra sir. Blessed are those who see beautiful things in humble space, in humble places where other people see nothing. The more grateful you are, the more you will attract. The more positivity you will attract. Good evening, fellow Toastmasters and dear guests. Wow, what a wonderful speech it was. A unique and intriguing title chosen by our dear speaker. A commendable job on the title chosen by you. It was a well-researched, well-presented, and a well-explained speech. The creative tool used by you was the PPT. And each and every slide was so detailed that we got to know everything, starting from these small things that we don't appreciate in our daily life. You made us value them today. Kudos to you. Who invented those? How were they invented? The whole interesting process. How was safety pin invented? To how was punch invented? You told us everything. Perfect details and well-researched speech. But there are some recommendations for you that I want to mention. The starting. You started with greeting everyone. I have a suggestion for you. Rather than starting with good evening everyone, you can tell us all a story and hook up the audience. Or you can tell some invention, any invention in the starting, so that we get to know that what you are going to speak about. There is a thrilling in the starting itself. Then I think due to a paucity of time, you were not able to manage the time a little, and your ending was a little bit abrupt. I felt that. So in order to avoid that, you can focus on your ending, because ending gives a moral, and the last statement of your speech is really important. So cutting and shortening down your body of the speech, you can focus more on your ending part. Third thing is voice modulation. When you were sliding the slides, you could use your voice modulation a little bit better in order to focus, and in order to focus on more points. So if you could change your tone in different slides, it could have been better. Otherwise, your hand gestures were graceful and connecting. They were very well coordinating with what you were speaking. For example, you spoke the way, "You're going to be disappointed." Five. It was really engaging, and you showed emotions also. So great job on that. The takeaway was that you used a very unique title. People don't usually speak on these things, and you connected with the audience really well, with the set of people you have never interacted. So all in all, objectives were fulfilled. The speech was well resourced, well presented. Your hand gestures were graceful. If you can work on the structure, the starting and the ending, and a little bit on voice modulation, you can take the speech to the next level. All the best for your further speeches. Over to TMOT, a general evaluator.
Thank you, Toastmaster Gursipat. So now this is the time I would request Techmaster to raise the ballot for the best speaker. Okay, so both the speakers have given their fantastic evaluation. They have followed the process which we have usually, the CRC approach. So I would like to commend then Toastmaster Nipun Ahuja talked about the various aspects of the speech delivered by Toastmaster Simran. And he has given the recommendation which was coupled with how speaker could portray, and the observation which made a point by Nipun Ahuja, then how she could improve the voice modulation and gesture. So that is well done. I would recommend Toastmaster Nipun, then you can talk about some speaker's objective of the particular project, where she could done it or not, or the content, because it was a great content given by the Toastmaster. So you can also describe then she was having a lot of other things. So that is the only recommendation for Toastmaster Nipun. And second evaluator, Toastmaster Gursipat Kaur Chawda, though she is a very veteran Toastmaster, and she started evaluating the speaker very well. And she has brought all the points which the speaker did fantastic in her speech. Only the recommendation for Toastmaster Gursipat, rather than using you and then pointing out, because your evaluation is for the entire audience, not for the speaker only. So you could say then speaker did this fantastically, and there's a speaker, and then you use the word otherwise. So otherwise, rather than you say then otherwise, so it will destroy the entire evaluation. So rather than you say what I feel, in my opinion, you could do well in this area. So that could be a little a good approach to give your commendation or recommendation to the speaker in a very positive note. And then you concluded well, and you were really good recommendation were provided with a great example. So thank you very much. So that is for the goalkeeper. So now this is the time for the auxiliary role players report. So
I would like to invite our auxiliary role player from the timer, Fed. So may I request timer, please give your timing report. Yeah, Fed. Hello.
Yeah. Thank you, Toastmaster Gurinder Curry. Am I audible?
Yes, yes.
Yeah. Almost everyone have completed their speeches within the provided time frame. Toastmaster Simran Dua has taken a 6:40, and Priyadarshini has exceeded her time limit today. She took 8:08, and Nipun Ahuja took 2:55, and Gursifat took 3:10. So that's the report of today. Over
thank
to you.
Toastmaster Fred. Okay, thank you. Thank you. So now this is the time to invite our second role player, debutant role player, auxiliary role player for language evaluator, Toastmaster Tanvi.
Yeah, thanks, journal evaluator, for inviting me. So I would like to share the language evaluation for Simran's speech. So Simran has used great tools like storytelling. She has used a lot of quotes in her speech. And another important, am I audible, guys? Yeah. Another important device used by Simran was repetition. She repeated a lot of words like silence does this, silence does that, which made her speech really interesting. Then she used repetition as a device another time when she said, farmers searched for this, but all in vain. So she tried to capture the audience and made her speech really interesting. Another important thing is use of transition words. She said that firstly, it does this, silence improves your wisdom, silence improves stress management. Thirdly, it improves your physical well-being. So use of transition words make the speech a kind of a memorable one for everyone. Everyone just remembers the fact then. And another important point, she used personal experience in the end, which made us retrospect and introspect as well. So almost we were involved in whatever she was saying. We even thought about, yes, silence is really a great trait to have. So that's my report for Simran. And then I move on to Priyadarshini's. So she, again, her style of presentation was very fact-oriented. She chose a very simple topic. She chose very simple objects, which we never imagined that could be of so much worth in our life. And she has also used a lot of transition words like next is this, lastly this. So which again made us remember the benefits of whatever objects you chose to give presentation on. One feedback is that since the topic that you chose was really banal and very simple, if you could have used a lot of rhetoric questions, which Shiv Priya was doing in her presentation, that don't you think what will happen if you are at a party and there is some emergency situation, you would need a safety pin. What would happen without a safety pin? So use of questions in your speech, again, make the speech interesting, even if the topic is very mundane.
Rumi, Tanvi, because we are already running short of time, so you can make it this report very quick.
Yeah, that's it. That's it from my side. Yeah.
Okay. Thank you. Thank you very much. So now the third FG role player is our counter, Rui. So may I request Rui, please provide your report in briefly.
Thank you, General Evaluator. Okay. So Karthik said one time. Simran used repetitive words 6 times and took 1 pause. Priyadarshini said one time, repetitive word 5 times. Shiv Priya used 4 times, and repetitive words 7 times. She used filler words once. Gajendra used A 3 times and Gulshifat 8 times. So this is my report. Thank you. Over to you, general evaluator.
Thank you. Thank you, counter. So let me give you the brief report for our auxiliary role players. So auxiliary role players did a fantastic job. I think all of them were debutant Toastmasters for their role. So kudos to them. They did great job. What I like to commend about Toastmaster language evaluator Tanvi, because she introduced the word in the chat box. And second thing, she also reminded us how we can remember the word of the day by using the gorilla. Then gorilla is after you, and that I really loved that. Only one recommendation for our auxiliary role player, because your report is for the entire speakers, not only for the speakers. So you can use what were the good uses and not so good uses rather than mentioning the particular speaker. So that you can take care in our other role. And Toastmaster Rui has thoroughly introduced her role crisply, and she did a fantastic job. So no recommendation for Toastmaster Rui. So Timer Fed has introduced his role very, but only the thing is that you can share the screen to display the card. With the first speaker, I was not noticed any signal for the time was there. So that is the only recommendation for the Toastmaster Fed. And now I would like to summarize the overall meeting very quick, because we are already running short of time, though I have lot to say, but due to paucity of time, I will cover up the major point only. So the meeting is started 3 minutes late. So only thing is that there was some dog barking sound at the meeting is started. So I request then you can close the door so there is no disturbances. President has brought very energy in that meeting, and then she has reminded us if we never quit, and I like that, if we never fail. And that was the takeaway. So it was a well done. Toastmaster of the day has imbibed the energy during the meeting by asking the questions from the audience. It was very well done. So only the recommendation, because Toastmaster of the day has given the stage control to the audience. And then when we came on to the second module, it was around 17 minutes late, which was scheduled 7:58, and then we were coming around 8:16. So that is the time because when you are moderating the meeting or you are emceeing the meeting, then you have the control over the thing. Then you are facilitating the meeting, you are not the speaker. And that point you have to remember in mind. Otherwise, the ballot connected in time, he was thoroughly engaging, and everything I liked about the Toastmaster of the day. Second thing, the module master, I think I have a lot to say about her, but due to paucity of time, I could not had that liberty to comment. So it was very informative, very engaging, with confidence and utmost sincerity, and with full insight it was delivered. And I really loved the session which is delivered by Toastmaster Cipriya. Only the couple of recommendation I also have for the module master. The number one, you have to plan your module with respect to the time, because the time is suited almost 17 minutes. So you can plan the question at the end, and you can take the time for 5 to 6 minutes to call the speakers, though you are planning it impromptu. So that you can take care whenever you are planning for the next module. Second thing, when you could share some resources for the audience, so because everybody were looking forward, then what next? So after this speech, maybe they will forget then what is actually been taught. So if could some share slide on a WhatsApp group or something like that, or any screen share you can, so then people make a note out of it. That would be, I think, add cherry on the cake for the evaluation. So all in all, I enjoyed the meeting, and I would like to give the stage back to our Toastmaster of the day.
Thank you so much, general evaluator, for giving such a great evaluation. Now, tell me, my friends, what is the most important, the most proudest feeling for any batsman?
What's the question?
What is the most proud feeling for a batsman?
Probably if he hits a century or a half century, or he wins a match.
Yes, most probably you are right. When a batsman scores his 100th run and the echo of the sound of claps comes into his ears, that is the most proudest feeling of a batsman. But before reaching to that, he has to face a lot of struggle. A lot of struggle. He has to face each and every delivery on the merits. He has to wait for the easy deliveries to come and respect the tough deliveries. So as we are doing in life, we have to wait for our time. We have to wait for our deliveries. This time, in this pandemic, we are facing the bouncers. We are facing the good line deliveries. That is the tough situation. And we have to stay positive. We have to give respect to it. We have to stay at home. Just to hear that clap, that sound of the clap, which one day we will shortly listen, just like Israel did. Now, I hope you all loved the session, enjoyed it, and I think that most of you would have now relate the session to the cricket. Cricket will be a more relatable thing to you now. Thank you so much, everyone, for being such a nice audience. What can I say? Thank you so much. And I will hand over the stage to the president of our club just by giving a quote. We may not win immediately, but we will win definitely. Thank you. Over to you, the president of the meeting.
Thank you, Kashish. That was a great meeting. You brought a lot of energy as a Toastmaster of the day. And it was great to see a lot of people attending in today. Yes, I spoke a little too much in the opening. And it also seems Kashish went from cover drive to overdrive. It took a lot of time. I humbly apologize to everyone for the delay and cancellation of table topics. Generally, that doesn't happen in our club, but sincerely apologize. Before we move on, I request everyone to please vote for the best role player of today. We had Toastmaster today, Toastmaster Kashish Jain, Table Topics Master, Toastmaster Darshan Singh, and the General Evaluator, Toastmaster Gajendra Kare. Yes, we had a great session by Toastmaster Shivpri as well, but we are no one to judge if that was a great session or not. It was by in itself a great session. We got a lot to learn. We vote for the people of our club who performed the role players of Toastmaster today, Table Topics Master and General Evaluator. Please vote very quickly. All right, I'm ending the polls in 5 seconds. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Ending the polls now. All right, so before I declare the results, I would request all the new Toastmasters that have joined us today. From my personal experience of attending after 2 weeks, I can totally see there's a huge dip in the quality of the meeting. And yes, I take it upon myself to not be at the optimum level of how CDTM has been performing. Me and Akshat had actually crafted a plan to ensure that your onboarding happens. We have, like, I think 11 or 12 people have joined in the past 1 month or so, and that would automatically definitely take some time to bring you up to speed. And so Faz, Ruhi, okay, I see Tanvi has left. All the new people that have joined in, we're trying to collate all the resources to ensure that you go through these scripts and then you practice and you rehearse. We also wanted to ensure that you, all of you have mentors, and then you connect with them, you talk to them about your roles prior, and then after you've delivered, you get feedback from them on whatever you've done, so that you always have this habit of improving after every single role. But we totally understand times are such that mentors cannot be available. So what you need to do now is that you need to reach out to the members of the EC, reach out to Akriti, reach out to Akshat, reach out to me, and reach out to Gursipat. All right, you have to reach out to these four people at least for the next 2 or 3 weeks. Every single role that you're going to take, someone will ensure first that you get the briefing done. You need to know what the flow of the meeting is. And then you need to rehearse your script with that specific Toastmaster from the EC. All right, ideally, we would want you to have this connect with your mentors. But yes, as per the feedback we've got, many mentors are not well. And we had to allocate a lot of mentees to mentors. So the balance is still not there for the next 3-4 weeks. Please do that. We're also trying to compile videos to ensure that whenever you have any doubt, you can refer to these videos and take a good feedback into your reports and your scripts. All right, so please bear with us for the next 2-3 weeks. The EC team will try and reach out to you and ensure you get proper support. But please understand, unless and until you come back, you reach out to the members, nothing is going to improve. All right, do not assume things and do it. I saw an example today. Our team has tried to reach out, but that didn't really happen, and we saw the result of that as well. So not the right way to go about it. For the next 1 or 2 months, put all that you've got. As a simple ready reckoner, as a simple guide, do 3 auxiliary role players in the next 3 weeks, deliver 1 or 2 speeches, take a 1 speech evaluation, be table topics master, and then do TMOD. All right, your schedule is packed for the next two months. Quite simple, 3 auxiliary role players, 1 or 2 speeches, take up at least 1 speech evaluation, do the table topics masters. All right, great. So I won't be holding you for long. I already see a lot of guests leaving in. I'll just declare the results now. The best speaker, we had Toastmaster Simran Dua, Toastmaster Priyadarshini. Whom do you think?
Toastmaster Simran.
Simran. Yes, Simran won on the account of time as well and on the account of votes as well. Congratulations, Toastmaster Simran. And the best auxiliary role player, we had timer Toastmaster Faiz, language evaluator Toastmaster Tanvi Girdhar, and our counter Toastmaster Rohi. Who won?
Toastmaster Tanvi.
It was language evaluator Toastmaster Tanvi Girdhar. All right. Best evaluator, we had 2 speeches. Toastmaster Nipun Ahuja was evaluating Toastmaster Simran's speech. And Toastmaster Gursipat Kaur Chabda evaluated Toastmaster Priyadarshini's speech. Who won? Any guesses, guys? It was just 2 evaluators. All right, it was our immediate past present, Toastmaster Gursipat Kaur Chabda. Congratulations, Gursipat. All right, then the gala prize, we had Toastmaster Uday, Toastmaster Kashish Jain, Table Topics Master, Toastmaster Darshan Singh, who couldn't deliver, real apologies for that. Then General Evaluator, Toastmaster Gajendra Kare. So who won between the youngest and the oldest? Deepak Menon is the oldest, but currently in the meeting, Toastmaster Gajendra Kare is the most experienced. So who won? Yeah. Some guesses, guys?
Toastmaster Kashish.
Yes, it was our youngest Toastmaster, Toastmaster Kashish Jain. Congratulations, Toastmaster.
Thank you. Thank you so much, everyone. Thank you.
All right, great, everyone. So sorry to be keeping you here for long. And thank you, Shiv Priya, for that great module. It's always a pleasure to have veteran Toastmasters visit our club. I'm sure our new Toastmasters would have picked up a lot of points today in framing a great speech. So thank you, everyone. See you next time today. And for all the new members, please be very diligent.